Hi everyone, this is Leonard Smith from Since Memory, and I bet you wonder where I'm coming from right now. I'm actually inside my closet, a closet that my brother helped me put together, and it really is lovely to have a closet you can actually go into and sit down and change your clothes in, and it's really wonderful, great walk-in closet, which I've never had before. The closet I had in San Francisco was teeny tiny, about this wide. And so this is a real luxury for me. So before we get started, I just wanted to show you some things, a very mini haul of things that just arrived. So, you know, I like bath gels, and I got this beautiful Terre d'Hermes bath gel from Hermes, and really excited to have that. And then this is really beautiful. I just used it and it's wonderful. It's bath gel of Shalimar. Really gorgeous oriental. So that is very exciting. And then a really wonderful, something I've wanted for a very long time, and it's the classic legendary Mustard Cartier for men. And look at that bottle. I'll be doing a review of this. And the top, it's amazing. This is so heavy and just really luxurious. And then the final thing I'm so very excited about, thanks to Super Jacob, is my brand new bottle of the classic, the original Dolce & Gabbana Pour Homme. And I'm just really excited to have this. So let's just open up really quick and take a look and get a little whiff of it. Just really, really, really very excited. This is one of Super Jacob's absolute favorite fragrances. Oh my God, the box is velvet. Wow, that's just really great. So the giveaway is about this. It makes you positive that it is vintage, and the original is that the cap should be blue, and the paper, the words on the outside of the box should be on a paper card attached to it. And there it is, paper, blue cap, paper. Oh my God, this is so exciting. So let's just give it a little. There we go. There we go. Hi, this is gorgeous. So this is definitely, thank you, Super Jacob. This is definitely going to get a review. But in the meantime, it's time to talk about one of my new favorite leathers. Stay tuned. The fragrance we're going to be discussing today is from the house of Aramis, and it's the original Aramis, and this is a division created by a division of Estee Lauder, and this is a really very surprising scent to me. It's becoming one of my absolute favorites. It's a woody chypre, and its main accords are woody, leathery, balsamic, and spicy and earthy. It was created by Bernard Chant. Now, Bernard Chant is a great perfumer from the 50s and 60s, and he's very well known for creating a fragrance that is one of the best leathers ever, and that is Cabochard by Gris. Now, the interesting thing is that when he created this amazing fragrance of Aramis, he used the exact same structure, bone structure, so to speak, to create this fragrance. So it is like a masculine version of the Cabochard, which I wear Cabochard all the time because I think it's a very unisex fragrance. And so Therefore, anyone, male or female, can certainly wear Aramis. It is a wonderful leather fragrance. I find it to be, most people would say that leather fragrances are mostly for fall and winter, but with the spring coming on, there's something about this that just really lends itself to spring for me. And that might be the pelargonium that is in here. Pelargonium is a kind of spicy floral note that is not used very much, but when it is, boy, does it really give a beautiful floral roundness to a leather like this. Now, the top notes in this fragrance are artemisia, bergamot, cinnamon, and gardenia. And I love a gardenia. That is one of my favorite white flowers. And of course, you know that a gardenia note is something that cannot be created in the lab. It's one of the few natural notes in nature, floral notes, that have to be synthesized or created by adding other notes together to create a kind of watercolored olfactory impression of the gardenia. Now, the mid notes are, as I said, pelargonium, patchouli, vetiver, and sandalwood. And the bottom notes are really where this fragrance just takes off. And that is this incredible, incredible leather. It's kind of a rough kind of leather. You know how the back of leather, like in a leather bag, if it doesn't have a lining, the back of the leather has a kind of texture to it. This leather has a texture to it that is just really rich and deep and just a perfect leather. It really is. I'm just so impressed with that. And of course, there's oak moss and amber. And the oak moss and the amber with that leather bring this into a classicism that is unparalleled and yet still very, very modern. I'm just absolutely in love with Aramis and so happy that I've gotten around to finally exploring this amazing fragrance. It, as I said, for me works great in spring, but of course it also is a perfect scent for winter. I would say semi-formal to formal. Evening is when I would wear it, but definitely, you know, like I always say, I think you can wear fragrance anytime you want. Just mixing it up and having fun with fragrance is what it's all about. So those are my impressions and my feelings about Aramis, and I hope that you'll give it a try. This is Landers Smith from Sense Memory saying, remember, wear what you love and not what they say you should like.